What's going on, my wealth builders? I'm Dean, your go-to guy for building wealth. And this workshop today is multiplying your money 101. And I'm going to introduce you guys to something that I've been working on for quite some time. And I think it'll be very lucrative for you guys to learn this method to multiply your money, as you can see it right here from the logo. So in this video, I'm going to be teaching you guys about options, why, or options. Options is I'm going to explain what that is. Also, why it's important and how you can get started. So it's going to be just a short introduction to options and get you familiar with it. So what are options? I want you to think of it like the Nike store, okay? So options are like having a coupon to buy Nike shoes. Imagine you have a special coupon that lets you buy a pair of Nike shoes at a set price, let's say $100, okay? So you have a special coupon that will let you buy the Nike shoes for $100. With that being said, it's only valid for 3 months. Okay. So we're all familiar with coupons, buy one, get one free, $100 off, whatever it may be. This one's saying you can buy any Nike shoes at $100 within the next 3 months. Okay. So now, because you have this coupon, you have the power to say, all right, I can buy this at a later date. So if the price goes up, I got it locked in for $100. I don't have to pay anything more. I can buy it for $100. Or the next thing you can do is you give that coupon to somebody else at a premium. So if someone says, hey, I want to buy a pair of shoes next month or whatever, would you be willing to sell that to me for $120? So because you bought it for $100, you can now sell it to somebody else for $120 and make $20 on top of it. So that's kind of like how options work. You're pretty much taking on the obligation to be like, hey, I'm going to buy whatever it is that you have at a specific price at a later date. Or if I don't buy it by that later date, I'm going to sell it and try to make some money off of it. So that's how options work. So let's go back to using the shoes. So the price goes up to $150 in the store. You can now use your coupon, that's $100. And you will save $50. But if the price drops down to $80, you wouldn't lose your coupon. If it goes under what you paid for it, so say it's on a deep discount where it's like $80. So if you could buy it cheaper without the coupon, then you're fine. But if you can't, then it is what it is. So the next thing is you have an expiry date. And if you decide whether to use a coupon within the 3 months, if you don't use it, it just expires. So you just end up losing $100. So it's good to just use it before it expires. Make sure you decide when you want to either sell the coupon or cash in that coupon to purchase your shoes. That's literally how options work with the stock market. So instead of buying a specific product, you're just saying, hey, I want to purchase company ABC shares at a later date at this price. So I'm going to lock in that price now. The price that you're locking it in for, what you're paying to have that is called a contract. And when you get that contract, you have the obligation to either purchase at that price or sell it to somebody else for profit. If you do decide to purchase it with buying the stocks later, that's what they call you're paying a premium to lock in that price. Because that price, who knows if it comes back down to it or it goes up, right? You're paying a premium for that price. So if you do decide to cash it later on, you paid $100, you get the shares at $100 or whatever price it is. But that $100 that you initially used to lock in that price, you would essentially lost that money, or it's rolled over into the share prices of the shares that you bought. Also with contracts, it works in sets of 100. So you just can't buy one option contract. You have to buy it in hundreds. So if you want to buy the Nike shoe coupon, it's $100 to lock in that price for those shoes. Next is why option? Because you can make money. This is literally how you can multiply your money. The way the option games work, it's crazy. Like, there's two ways that you could do it. You could be a long-term holder, or you can be a short-term trader, scalper, whatever it may be. But I would suggest doing long term, because going back to what I was saying about the shoes have an expiry date. So if you have 3 months, you kind of want to give yourself more time to let the price of that stock move however it wants to move, but hopefully in your direction, which is up. So you want to kind of learn the options game, because if you have long term positions, you can literally print money in the market. And when you're ready to pull out, money's right there for you. Just like the coupon, it gives you the choice to buy the shoes at a good price. Options give you flexibility. You can take advantage of price changes in the market without having to actually own the stocks or the shoes right away. So if the market's going crazy, but you say, hey, It's moving between 150 and 80 bucks. You say, you know what? I want to lock in at $100 and just wait to see coming closer to my expiration date. As you buy it, it starts to go below. You're down some money, but because you have a long-term contract, you don't really have to panic so much or panic at all, right? Now it gets closer to your expiry date and you're like, oh, it's up $140. I'm going to sell it to somebody. I don't want to buy shoes at this time. Right there, you're going to make $40 based off of you selling your contract or your coupon to somebody else. Strategy and protection. So options can be used to protect your investment, kind of like an insurance policy. If you own Nike stocks and worry about the price dropping, buying a put option can help you limit your losses. So the coupon that I just explained to you, imagine there was a reverse coupon. So let's say you actually own the shoes and you want it to maintain its value. You would buy like a reverse contract that I said earlier, the coupon. I don't know what you'll call it, reverse to a coupon, but that would protect your shoes staying at that price that you bought it for. Oh, it's almost like a warranty. Like, you know, when you go to the store and they're like, hey, I'll buy this warranty if your phone breaks, you can replace it for the latest model. Think of it like in that term, not so much the latest model. However, when you do a put or taking out an insurance policy on your shoes. So if the price goes down in value and you bought a put, then you would make money when it goes down, which would cover the difference in whatever your shoe price was. That's the market driving it down. The one that I was explaining earlier, they call that a call. That's pretty much how the option game works. You can buy options either to go up or you can buy it to go down. That's why I like options versus the stock market. Stock market's good, don't get me wrong, but long-term positions. Option positions, you can buy it to what to go up or to go down. So it's like you have a 50-50 shot there. Whereas if you just purchase stocks, you can only purchase it to go on. That's why I like the options trading. You can use less money to get into the market and be able to make money in the stock market. One thing that I do want to emphasize to you guys is how to stay calm and focused. That is one of the biggest challenges that I've had. And I know that whoever starts trading options or is trading options that's struggling, you're probably going through this. And this is something to help you guys just to navigate through option trading. So think of yourself as a captain sailing a ship through both a calm and stormy seas. Here's how to do it. Know your map. Understand the basics of option trading very well. Just like knowing the sea routes help captain. Knowing how options work, include their risk, their reward, and help people stay calm. Set your course. So before you start, decide on how much money you're okay with risking and what your goals are. This is like setting your destination before you sail. If you can just close your eyes and imagine yourself planning a vacation for yourself, you don't just pick up yourself and leave, right? You figure out where is it you want to go, how much it's going to cost, when you want to go, all these things. That's exactly how you got to think of it for options. What's the price I'm getting in? How much am I willing to lose based off of this trade? You do all that stuff and that will help you with your trading journey. Just like if you're on a boat, you want to go from A to B, you got to map it out. Next, prepare for the storms. The sea of option trading can get rough. Prices go up and down really fast. Decide in advance how you'll handle big changes. How will you hold steady? Or do you have a plan to adjust your sails? When the captain sees that a storm's coming, right? They take down the sails so that the boat doesn't move that much in the water, right? Just mainly with the waves. But if they have the sails open and it's pushing the boat, and it's really like, and a storm's coming, you're just gonna go all over the place. It could potentially rip your sail, it'll take longer for you to get to your destination. All these things can happen. So when you're trading options, don't take a active approach, take a proactive or a reactive approach. And what I mean by that is be on the defense more than the offense. The offense is great, but you need to know how to manage your risk. Don't play this like the lottery, like, oh, I'm gonna keep playing until I make my money. Don't chase your losses. These are all things that I've done. And trust me, the amount of money that I've lost because I've done this is not a good feeling. So I'm begging you, please do not do those things. I'm telling you what to do to avoid these things so that you keep more money in your pocket. Going back to what I was saying, figure out how much am I willing to lose. Don't even worry about how much you're willing to make, willing to lose. Because once you can get over that or see it happening, you'll already be prepared for it and it won't be such a big blow to you. Like in the army, these guys have to wake up 7 a.m. or 6 a.m. every morning and like they have to just train themselves to do these things, right? Have to go out in the de not desert, but like on a hiking trail with like a 20, 30, 40-pound bag up a hill, maybe have to survive in the forest. They're preparing them for the worst. In a book I read, this is a great book, by the way. Oh, you guys can't even see it. Oh, there we go. The obstacle is the way. And I'm learning that from this book, where the first time NASA went to the moon, they prepared the astronauts for anything that could possibly go wrong. Like, and they call it like panic mode or something like that. And because they did that, they were able to go through these cycles over and over again. So if it was to happen to them, they would already be prepared for it. It's like jumping in a pool, not knowing how to swim. If someone just keeps pushing you in a pool and you just keep learning how to either float or s to start to swim, guess what? Next time someone pushes you in a pool, you're not gonna be like, oh, drowning. You're just gonna be fine. You'll be like, whatever, and swim back to wherever, right? So that's how you wanna treat options, okay? So make sure you have your plan set up. Okay, what if this happens? What if that happens? Even being prepared for when you're gonna make money, but start with what you're willing to lose first. From there, then you can figure out, okay, how much am I looking to make off of this trade? Have an exit strategy. Big companies do this all the time. They come up with an idea and they say, all right, my exit strategy, or this is the amount of money I need to exit out of this business so that I can live my dream life. You're not going to get your dream life off of one trade, but say to yourself, all right, I'm looking to make X amount of dollars on this trade. If it's like a long-term position, you can aim for like 100%. Close the trade, buy another contract, and do it again. Rinse and repeat. Just come up with a formula and just stick with it. It gets boring, but boring is that's what makes money. Prepare for the storm. So we've talked about that. Keep a logbook. So track your trades like a captain logs their journey. This helps you learn what happens and stays focused on your trading strategy, not just your feelings. Take your emotions out of it. This is not something for emotional people. If you're very emotional about losing money, this might not be for you. You might want to do something less risky, but with all risk comes reward. Practice calm sailing. So sometimes you might want to react quickly to the market changes, but remember, being calm like the Stoic means taking a moment to think before you act. Make sure your decisions fit with your plan. So going back to what I was saying, just practice, practice, practice. The better you get at it, the more confident you'll be in your trading, and then you don't have to worry. I bought this for myself. It's a phone lock so that I can't look at my phone after I'm done trading. This is more so for day trading. The long-term trades I have months, so I don't even have to worry about that. But the daytime trading, just so that I'm not looking at my phone or trying to just jump into trades. It's like, nope, not touching it. I'm just gonna wait until the lock opens, and then I can use my phone again. If someone wants to call me, they can call me, and that's the most I can do. It's to help me stay focused on what matters at that moment. So if you guys want to get something like that, you can get it from Amazon. Just type in phone lock. Enjoy the journey. So remember, trading options is just one part of your adventure. Don't let it take over all your thoughts and your emotions. Enjoy other things in life too. If you made money, if you're doing short-term trading and you made money, log off the computer and go do something. Try to do something that's non-digital, something meditate, read a book, take a walk. I don't know, drink some water. Oh, you guys can see my water. Oh, there we go. Drink some water. This is my new water bottle. It's called the Air Up. Apparently, when I drink water from this, it tastes like, or I have a pot on it, the scent comes into my nose and it makes the water taste like that. It doesn't really work for me, but whatever. So we talked about what are options, how it works, or why you should trade options. Some things to help you just stay calm and stay focused. And the next thing that you want to do, if this is something that you're eager to learn about, you want to open an account, and they call it a brokerage account. You could either do this with your bank, you can do this with Interactive Brokers, you can do this with Questrade, Ameritrade, TD Ameritrade, E-Trade, all these platforms. I think Robinhood as well. So depending on what country you're in, you can use any of these platforms. But today I'm just going to specifically talk about Interactive Brokers. And if you're in Canada, this is the platform that I use. So you want to navigate to the website, access the Interactive Brokers site, locate open account, hit that button, and that starts the registration process. So next, you want to select an account. You'll be prompted to choose the type of account you wish to open: individual, joint, trust. Select the option that best aligns with your investment goals and needs. If you're doing long-term trading, you can use your TFSA account, you can use your RSP account, but if you're using any of those two accounts, you have to remember what happens when you withdraw money from those accounts. The TFSA, it's a tax-free savings account, but you're only allowed to take out a specific amount each year. Reach out to a licensed professional for more details on that. If it's an RSP account, so your retirement savings account, don't pull money out of there, because if you pull money out and you're not of age, you're going to get taxed real heavy on that. So don't use those two accounts. I use just a regular account. I will have to pay taxes, but now if you're asking yourself, oh, what about taxes? Are you trying to make money or are you going to cry about how much you have to pay the government? Imagine you make $1 million from trading options. Are you really going to cry that you have to pay the government taxes? Like, who cares? You made money, right? I need you to start thinking like that. Just unlearn, relearn these things. So you select your account, then you're going to get an application form, provide all the required personal and financial information accurately. This includes details such as your name, address, employment information, financial status, and investment experience. Answer to the best of your abilities. If you need help, you can reach out to me in the Wealth Builders community down in the discussion. I'll leave a link. If you're watching this on YouTube, I'll leave a link down in the description for you to join the Wealth Builders Academy. Review the terms and conditions, carefully read through them, and yeah, read through them before you open your account so you know what you're getting into. It's crucial to understand all these aspects in the agreement with Interactive Brokers before proceeding. And then you have identification verification. So that's a part of your Know Your Customer, the KYC. I feel like this came in all because of crypto, but it's whatever. You'll be required to submit identification documents. Typically, this includes government issued ID, passport or driver's license, proof of residence, such as a utility bill or bank statement. Once you got that all done and they say, congratulations, you got an account, now you can fund your account. So choose the funding method, deposit the funds in there. Options may include bank transfer, wire transfer, or transferring assets from one brokerage to another brokerage. Minimum deposit required, depending on the account that you selected. You can start with any amount. If you're doing options, $1,000 is okay. I trade in US dollars to do the options. I don't trade Canadian options, I do US options. So just to let you guys know, what I do is I do it as a bill payment to Interactive Brokers, and within like 2 days they get my money. After all that's done, you wait for approval, application required. Yeah, so between the funding and identification verification, you get approved, then you're done, then you're activated. Then just review the platform with your account activated and funded. You now can log in Interactive Brokers platform by familiarizing yourself with the interface and the tools available. So get familiar with using it. I would suggest starting with a paper trading account just so that you can figure out all the bells and whistles about it. If you're a part of the Wealth Builders Academy, you'll have access to all the videos that walk you through step by step on how to set up the account. For additional training, if this is something that you're interested in and learning more on the options trading, I'm going to be doing a group training with 20 people. There will be a cost associated with it, but if this is something that you're interested in, you need to be a part of the Wealth Builders Academy to get access to this training. And thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for the next video. Peace out.